Awesome! This is going to be a great lesson. Nickelback's new song, Gotta Be Somebody. We're going to run through some chords, and it's really, really easy. Yeah. First of all, we have a C chord, which is probably the most known and used chord in guitar, as you probably know. We've got a G chord, we've used them all before. We've got an A minor chord. And then we've got an F chord. The F chord you can use in this way. I like doing this. Or you can just do the bar chord F. Depending on where you are in the song and what you want to do. So maybe let's just look at that sequence. 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. I also add my thumb at the back here. As you can hear, I'm counting you in. There's a 2-bar count for each chord in the verse. So basically, la 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 la. And I'm a little bit sick, so I won't sing today. La 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 la. Now what you could do to make it a little bit more interesting is add a few notes on top. What you could do is you play the chord, and as you play it, you keep on playing the one note, which is the root note of that chord. If you don't understand that language, it's alright, don't worry. Just kind of play what I play, which is this. La 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 la. Which is the wrong chord, so I'll just do that again. La 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 la. If you do this, you're going to have that whole effect of the bass guitar playing. Remember, there's a whole band, Nickelback, playing this song. You don't have all these instruments. You're probably playing with a guitar like this on your grandma's stoop or something, wherever you are.
What's a stoop?
Okay, so a stoop is a veranda. That's something we do in South Africa. We do a braai, which is called a barbecue, and you do it on the stoop, which is the veranda. If you don't know what I'm talking about, come down here and I'll show you. Just get my number. The family for a little arrangement like that. Anyway, this is the C chord. We play the C chord and we just bounce on the note on top, on the C note. Now remember, there's no band playing with you, so you have to kind of fill in for the whole band. It just drives the song a bit more. You could go for the old fashioned la la. Boring, it sounds like everything else, so I'd rather just stick with what I have here. And then there's a pre-chorus, which is just pre to the chorus, and it goes like this. It's got a D minor, but I think it's better just to play the D fifth chord, and especially since you don't have a band, you're just gonna have to drive it a little bit more to get that drums and bass feel. So you're gonna be going for this. Instead of playing the old-fashioned D minor chord, you're gonna be playing 1, 2, 3, these three notes, fret 5, fret 7, and pinky below fret 7. You could also do what I do most of the times, you probably catch me doing this. I use my pinky to play both of these notes. You can also add the note below, which is going to make it a major and a minor in that case. But just go for this, these three ones. Okay, so it's this, over there, and over there. So the pre-chorus starts with this funny D minor fifth chord, or D fifth chord. La 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 la. F5, G5, wait one bar. La 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 la. And that's basically the whole song. Practice it. See you next time.